I'm a dacint boy just landed from the town of Ballyfad. I want a situation and I want it very bad. I've seen employment advertised, it's just the thing, says I. But the dirty spalpeen ended with no Irish need apply. Ah, says I, but that's an insult, though to get the job I'll try. So I went to see this blaggar with his no Irish need apply. Some may think it a misfortune to be christened Pat or Dan, but to me it is an honour to be called an Irish man. Well, I started out to find the place, I got it very soon. There I found the old lad seated, he was reading the Tribune. I told him what I came for, when he in a rage did fly. No, says he, you are a Paddy, and no Irish need apply. Then me dandher started rising, and I'd like to black his eye. But I cooled it down and asked him, why no Irish need apply? Some may think it a misfortune to be christened Pat or Dan, but to me it is an honour to be called an Irish man. And says I to him, your ancestors came over here like me to try and make a living in this land of liberty. They were greeted here with dignity and taught to reap and sow by the Indians who owned this land. They didn't tell you no. But I'll get a job in spite of you, for I've willing heart and hand. Thank God there's better men than you all over this great land. Some may think it's a misfortune to be christened Pat or Dan, but to me it is an honour to be called an Irishman. And they say that in America it always is the plan, that an Irish man is just as good as any other man. A home and hospitality they never will deny to strangers here, or ever say no Irish need apply. But there's some bad apples here and there, a dirty lot, says I, and a dacent man will never write no Irish need apply. Some may think it a misfortune to be christened Pat or Dan, but to me it is